Welcome you all to the new session of Laplace Transform, and this is the last session in which we shall be discussing how to solve the differential equations and how to get the solutions of the differential equations with the boundary conditions given and without solving the particular integrals or without finding the values of the arbitrary constants. So let us consider the equation. So we have the equation d cube y by dx cube plus d of d square y by dx square minus of dy by dx minus of 2y equal to 0. So this is our differential equation. We have to find its solution, and we are given the boundary conditions that the y value is 0, dy by dx is 0 at x equal to 0, and also the double derivative d square y by dx square value is 6 at x is equal to 0. So we have to solve this equation and we have to find the solution of the differential equation. So let us look at the solution, how to solve it. So how we shall solve? The first step or the initial step to solve the differential equation is to take the Laplace transform on both the sides. So we shall take the Laplace transform on both the sides. So we are taking the Laplace on each of the term of the differential equation. So d cube y by dx cube is written as y triple prime. Double derivative is written as y double prime. Single derivative is written as y prime. And y is written as y itself. So we have to take the Laplace on each of the terms of the differential equation. So we have applied the Laplace here. Since that was 2 of d square y by dx square, so 2 is constant, so it comes out of the Laplace, that is 2 Laplace y double dash minus Laplace of y dash minus of 2 Laplace of y plus Laplace of y triple dash is equal to 0. So this is the Laplace of y triple dash. So y triple dash means the Laplace has to be carried out on the third order of the differential equation. And we have the formula for the Laplace of the derivative, which is that it is whatever is the order of the differentiation, the power of s starts from the same order of the differentiation. So we have s cube. Then with s cube, we have the Laplace of y. For the Laplace of y, we shall be representing it by y bar. So Laplace of y, that was written as f of s, in the term of the differential equation, we denote the f of s by y bar. Then minus s square y at x is equal to 0, that was f of 0, which means this is y value at x is equal to 0. Then the power of the s are subsequently decreasing by 1, and there is a negative value also every time. So negative sign is taking place in each of the terms. So we get now the third term is minus s dy by dx at x is equal to 0, which is represented by y dash at x is equal to 0, minus of y double dash at x is equal to 0. So this term is for the Laplace of y triple dash. Then we have the term 2 Laplace of y double dash. So now the Laplace is carried on the second order derivative of the function. So we have 2 outside. We have s square y bar minus of s value of y at x is equal to 0, then minus of y dash at x is equal to 0. Then carrying the Laplace of y dash, so we get minus is there outside, we get s of y bar minus of y at x is equal to 0, and for Laplace of y, we are writing it as y bar. So we get these equations. So now what shall we be doing? We shall be collecting the terms of y bar, y value at x is equal to 0, y dash at x is equal to 0, and the y double dash at x is equal to 0, and the constant terms. So collecting the coefficients of the various y bar, y 0, y dash 0, and y double dash 0, we get the terms as s cube plus 2s square minus s minus 2. For y 0, the coefficients are minus s square minus 2s plus 1. For y dash 0, we have the coefficient minus s minus 2s. For y double dash 0, we have the coefficient of minus 1. And since on the right-hand side of the equation, we had 0, so the Laplace of 0 is 0. So on the right-hand side, we have the value as 0. So we have these terms. Now, since in the previous as that y value or dy by dx value is 0 at x is equal to 0 and the double derivative at x is equal to 0 is 6. So we shall be substituting the values of y0, y dash 0, y double dash 0 and getting the results. So you can see here we have substituted the value of y0 which is 0. For y dash 0 also we had substituted the value 0 and for y double dash we have substituted a value of 6. So now the second and the third term gets vanished and we get the equation as y bar into x cube plus 2x square minus of s minus 2 is plus 6. Or we can say that the y bar is 6 upon s cube plus 2s square minus s minus 2, or it is 6 upon s minus 1 upon s square plus 3s plus 2. Quick equation. We had chosen by Hitton trial method that if we substitute the value of s is equal to 1, then s is equal to 1 is the solution of the difference of this cubic equation. So I divide my equation, cubic equation, by s minus 1. So my remainder is 0, you can see, and the quotient I get is s square plus 3s plus 2. So that I can make the factors of the cubic equation as s minus 1 into s square plus 3s plus 2. So the equation I had was now y bar is 6 upon s minus 1 s square plus 3s plus 2. For the quadratic equation, I have further broken down into the factors as s plus 2 into s plus 1. So now I have three linear factors in my denominator. So I shall be solving the equation with the help of the partial fractions. So I have written my equation as a upon s minus 1 plus b upon s plus 2 plus c upon s plus 1. Now taking the LCM on the right hand side, I get it as that my numerator 6 will be equivalent to a into s plus 2 into s plus 1 plus b times s minus 1 into s plus 1 plus c times s minus 1 into s plus 2. So that when I solve the equation, I can take out the coefficients of s square, s and constant. So the coefficient of my s square comes out to be a plus b plus c. The coefficient of s is 3a plus c. And the coefficient of the constant is 2a minus b minus 2c. And on the left hand side, I can see that the coefficient is there only for the constant term, that is 6. So the coefficient of s square is equal to 0, the coefficient of s is also equal to 0, and the coefficient of the constant is equal to 6. So by solving the three linear equations, I can get the value of three constants, that is the values of a, b, c, because to solve get the values of three constants, I need three linear equations. I have three linear equations, I can get the values of the constants. So by solving these three linear equations, I get that my a is equal to 1, b is equal to 2, and my c is equal to minus 3. Now, I shall be substituting the value of a in this equation, b in this equation, and the value of c in this equation. So I rewrite my equation of y bar as y bar is equal to 1 upon s minus 1 plus 2 upon s plus 2 minus of 3 upon s plus 1. So now I apply the inverse Laplace transform on the above equation. So when I apply the inverse Laplace transform, I have to apply the inverse Laplace transform on each and every term. So Laplace inverse y bar is equal to Laplace inverse of 1 upon s minus 1 plus 2 times Laplace inverse of 1 upon s plus 2 minus 3 times Laplace inverse of 1 upon s plus 1. So now applying the Laplace inverse formulas, this is the formula for e to power of at. So I get the formula as e to power x. I get the second term as 2 times e to the power minus 2x and minus 3 e to the power minus x. So in this way, without finding the value of the particular integral or solving the values of the arbitrary constants, I get the solution of the differential equation. So we can, in this way, we are able to see how Laplace transforms are able to get the solution of the differential equation without solving the particular integrals. So let us again see what we have done for this differential equation. The very first step was to take the Laplace transform on both the sides. The first step is to take the Laplace transform, then apply the Laplace transform formulas on the each derivative functions. Then whatever boundary conditions are given, apply those boundary conditions, solve it, take the y bar coefficients on one side, segregate y bar, and then on the left hand side just retain your y bar and take everything on the right hand side. Then try to solve the right hand side as linear factors, and you can use the method of partial fractions to solve the denominators. And then the last step is to apply the inverse Laplace transform on the y bar equation so that we get the final solution of the differential equation. So the first step is to take the Laplace transform on both the side. Second is to get the y bar, keep just y bar and take everything on the right hand side and try to simplify the y bar as far as possible. And then the last step is to apply the inverse Laplace transform on both the sides. So in this way, we are able to solve the differential equation using the Laplace transform. Yes, let us look at another problem of the differential equation. Let us solve another differential equation. So the differential equation given here is the ty double dash plus 2y dash plus ty is equal to sine t, where the boundary conditions given are y0 is equal to 1 and y dash 0 is equal to 0. So the first step was to take the Laplace transform on both the sides. So we are taking the Laplace transform. So it comes out to be Laplace of ty double dash plus 2 times Laplace of y dash plus Laplace of ty, which is equal to Laplace of sine t. In the previous question, on the right hand side, we had a factor of 0. So on the right hand side, everything was 0. Now in this problem, the right hand side is not 0. Its value is sine t. So we have to take the Laplace of the right hand side also. So now it is the Laplace of t of ft. You can see the first term, that is Laplace of t y double dash. So the formula for the Laplace of t of ft was minus 1 raised to power 1 d by ds of Laplace of ft, which is f of s. So now in this term, our ft is y double dash. So we get the equation as minus of d by ds of Laplace of y double dash. And then when we have the Laplace of y double dash, so Laplace of y double dash means it is the Laplace of the derivative of the function. So on the Laplace of y double dash, we have to apply the formula of the derivative function. So we get s square y bar minus of s y zero minus of y dash zero. So this is how this is the Laplace of t of y double dash is solved. Then we have the term of t of Laplace of y dash. So we have 2 times for Laplace of y dash, it becomes s y bar minus of y zero. Again, we have the Laplace of t of y, which can be written as minus of d by ds of Laplace y. So minus of d by ds of Laplace y will be written as minus d by ds of y bar, because Laplace y is y bar. And the Laplace of sine t was 1 by s square plus 1. So we get this result. So now you can see here we have d by ds of s square y bar minus of s y 0 minus of y dash 0. Either you take the derivative first, or you can substitute the values of y 0 and y dash 0 also. So we have in the boundary conditions given that y0 is 1 and y dash 0 is 0. So we substitute the values. So we get minus of d by ds into s square y bar minus of s into 1, because y0 is 1 and y dash 0 is 0. So we substitute the values, plus 2 s y bar minus of 1 minus of d by ds of y bar is equal to 1 upon s square plus 1. Now we have taken the derivative of the bracketed term. So what we get minus, since it is s square y bar, so we get minus 2 s y bar minus of s square into d by ds of y bar. We have applied the chain rule on the first term, that is s square y bar. Then for s it becomes 1, and then it is 2 s here. From this term we get 2 s y bar minus of 2. So this is this term, and we have minus of ds by y bar. So we get the term as minus of ds by y bar, which is equal to 1 upon s square plus 1. So now we collect the terms or the coefficients of dy bar by ds. So we get minus of s square minus 1 dy bar by ds is equal to 1 upon s square plus 1 plus 1. So dy bar by ds is equal to minus 1 upon s square plus 1 ka whole square minus 1 upon s square plus 1. So the first step was to take the Laplace transform on both the sides, and then it was to collect the terms of y bar. So now we take the Laplace inverse on both the sides. So we get Laplace inverse of d by ds of y bar is Laplace inverse of minus 1 upon s square plus 1 ka whole square minus Laplace inverse of 1 upon s square plus 1. So now we know that the Laplace inverse of d by ds of fs is minus 1 t times ft. So for this term, it is minus of t of y. So we get minus ty. For this term, it is minus half sine t minus of t cos t. I have applied the direct formula for this term, and we know that Laplace inverse of 1 upon s square plus 1 is sine of t. So this t is taken to the right hand side, and minus sign is also taken into care. So I get the result as 1 half t, 1 by 2 denominator t into sine t minus half cos t plus sine t by t, which gives sine t by t terms are clubbed to get the answer as 3 by 2 sine t by t minus half cos t, or half is taken common out. So we get the result as half times 3 sine t by t minus of cos t. So I hope that you are able to understand how to solve the differential equations. Just remember what were the various formulas while you apply the Laplace transforms or the inverse Laplace transforms. Apply the formulas very carefully and don't be in a hurry to apply the formulas. Take the positive negative signs into consideration and apply it. The first step is to take the Laplace transform on both the sides, then collect the coefficient of y bar, apply the boundary conditions, and then the last step is to apply the inverse Laplace transform. In this way, we are able to get the solution of the differential equation. So now let us look at the method how to solve the linear differential equations having two variables. So now we are given the linear differential equation as 4y plus dx by dt is equal to 0, and the other equation is minus 9x plus dy by dt equal to 0. And the boundary conditions are given that the x value is 2 at t equal to 0 and y is 1 at t equal to 0. So the first step, again, it is to apply the Laplace transform on both the sides. So now the Laplace transform on both the sides application will be applied on both the equations. So I have segregated in two halves. So I have written here that when I apply the Laplace transform on the first equation number A, I get 4y bar plus s x bar minus of x0, because it is the Laplace of the derivative of x. So Laplace of the derivative of x is sx bar minus x0, and on the right hand side I have 0, so I get the value of 0 on the right hand side of the equation number A. So I get this equation. So I know that the value of x at t equal to 0 is 2. So when I substitute the value of x0 equal to 2 and take it on the right hand side, I get the equation as 4y bar plus sx bar is equal to 2. Now I apply the Laplace transform on equation number B. I get the equation as minus 9x bar plus, since it is again the Laplace of the derivative of y equation, so I get the equation as sy bar minus y0, and on the right hand side again it is 0, so right hand side is again 0. So when I substitute the value for y at t equal to 0, I get my equation as minus 9x bar plus sy bar is equal to 1. So now I have two differential equations, linear differential equation in terms of x bar and y bar. So I will be solving these two linear equations with the method I have shown here. So first of all, I multiply the first equation by 4 and then with s and subtract it. so that I get the value of x bar, which is equal to minus 4 plus 2s upon s square plus 36. Similarly, I multiply the first equation by s and second equation by 9 and add the two equations. When I add the two equations, I get my value of y bar, where y bar is coming out to be s plus 18 upon s square plus 36. So the second step is to now apply the inverse Laplace transform on both x bar and y bar equations. So I have applied the Laplace inverse on the x bar equation. So it can be written as Laplace inverse of x bar is Laplace inverse of minus 4 plus 2s upon s square plus 6 square. 36 can be written as s square plus 6 square. And similarly, when I apply it on y bar, I get the equation as Laplace inverse of y bar is Laplace inverse of s upon s square plus 36 plus 18 upon s square plus 6 square. So I segregate my Laplace inverse on the two terms. I write it as minus 4 times Laplace inverse of 1 upon s square plus 6 square. Since it is related to the sine 60, so I multiply the numerator by 6 and divide it by 6 also, so that my numerator remains 1. And 6, I want that then my term will be 6 upon s square plus 36, and this 6 which is in the denominator is taken out, so that I get it as minus 4 by 6 sine of 60. So 4 by 6 can be further reduced to get the answer as 2 by 3. So the answer would be 2 by 3 sine 60 plus 2 cos of 60. And this term is Laplace inverse of s upon s square plus 6 square, which is equal to cos 60, and here it is sine of 60. Similarly, when I apply it on the y bar equation, Laplace inverse, so I again segregate into two terms. So for s upon s square plus 6 square, it is written as cos 60, and 18 is written as 3 times 6, which is equal to 3 Laplace inverse of 6 upon s square plus 6 square, which can be written as 3 sine of 60. So by using the Laplace transforms, we can apply it on the linear equations, and we have able to get the solutions of the x and y variable. So the Laplace transforms are very much efficient in calculating the solutions of the differential equations, either be a quadratic linear equation, or it is a differential equation of the order 3, 4, or it is a linear equations of two variables. So we can solve the differential equations by using the Laplace transforms. So the very first step is to apply the Laplace transform, then segregate the terms or take the coefficient of x bar and y bar on the other side and leave just x bar and y bar. And the next step is to take the inverse Laplace transform. So by making use of these steps, we are able to find the solutions of x and y in the linear equations.